Hi, this is Dan Willey from Fruitmentor. In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up an account and place an order for citrus budwood from California's Citrus Clonal Protection Program, or CCPP. I've timed it and I found that this can be done in less than 5 minutes of effort. They have hundreds of citrus varieties to choose from, many varieties that you would never find in the nursery, not because they're not great, but just because they're not well known. Before I get started with the demonstration, I'm going to give a little background on why, if you're going to graft citrus, it is so important that you order from a program such as the CCPP. Here you see I have a picture of orange blossoms. I have a story from St. Petersburg, Florida, where I've heard that if one were to walk around St. Petersburg in February 10 years ago, you would be overwhelmed with the smell of the sweet orange blossoms from the residential citrus trees all over the city. However, if you were to walk around St. Petersburg at that time these days, you wouldn't smell that. And the reason for that is the trees are all dead and dying. They've been infected by a disease called citrus greening. Here you see a photo of an orange tree infected with citrus greening, which is also known as huanglongbing, or HLB. The leaves have a characteristic asymmetrical yellow discoloration, and the fruit stays green and doesn't turn orange, and it tastes terrible. Citrus greening is spread by an insect called the Asian citrus psyllid, or ACP. It was introduced into Florida in the late 1990s, although the initial population did not have the citrus greening disease. Asian citrus psyllid spread rapidly throughout Florida, and in 2005, citrus greening was first discovered in a pomelo tree south of Miami. It's believed that the disease came via infected pomelo cuttings smuggled from Asia. Based on experience from Brazil, scientists in Florida expected that citrus greening would spread about 12 miles per year in Florida. It turned out that it spread a lot faster, consuming the whole state in just a few years. In 2014, the trees that remain in Florida are mostly dead or dying of this disease. Here you see a photo of an infected tree on the right and an apparently healthy tree on the left. One thing that's really terrible about this disease is that a tree can appear healthy but actually be infected and spreading the disease, and it doesn't even show up on a test. So even though this tree on the left looks healthy, more likely than not, it's actually infected and spreading the disease. In 2008, the greening-spreading Asian citrus psyllid was first discovered in Southern California, and it's been moving northward ever since. In 2012, citrus greening was detected in a residential citrus tree in Los Angeles. It turns out there was a pomelo graft on that tree, and it's believed that the source was smuggling from Asia. Although citrus cuttings from Asia are still a concern, the disease is now firmly established in the United States, so citrus cuttings from anywhere in the United States are now suspect and could spread the disease. 10 years ago, it used to be common for Californians to meet for scion exchanges where they would swap citrus cuttings from their trees at home so they could graft different varieties. With these recent developments, it's become very uncool to graft with citrus cuttings from home. Not only is it uncool, it's also illegal. The only way to legally graft citrus in California is to use budwood from a clean budwood program such as the CCPP. This photo shows the Ccpp facility where the budwood comes from. The screen houses here are insect resistant, so the disease-carrying insects cannot get into the facility and contaminate the budwood. There are no more citrus scion exchanges, but I don't miss them at all. The Ccpp is a much better way to order citrus budwood. They have hundreds of varieties to choose from, and given the recent events, they've made it easier and cheaper for people to order budwood. The program is not for just nurseries. Homeowners are welcome to sign up, and actually the vast majority of the accounts are from homeowners and not nurseries. And even people out of state can sign up and order, although at an increased expense because of the requirement of a USDA inspection of the budwood. there's a minimum order of 6 buds that's reduced from 12, meaning for someone in California, you can try a citrus variety for only $4.50. They also have inexpensive shipping. They have a great deal with FedEx, where even for a medium box, I found that the shipping cost within California is only about $10. And now the bud cutting is done on a monthly basis, so you can graft any time of the year that you'd like to. Now I'll show the demonstration where I set up an account and ordered budwood for a friend.
So first, go to the CCPP website. I'll include a link to that below. Go to the top of the page and click on budwood. Click the button to accept the terms and conditions. And there's an email address. There's a hyperlink there. If you have your email program configured, you can just click, or in my case, I'm using webmail, so I right-click and copy the email address. Compose an email and paste in the address. I'll write a subject and an introduction. And then we'll go back to the CCPP webpage and we'll copy everything that they're asking for. So just copy what's requested, paste that in the email, and then fill it out. One thing to note, the last thing in the requested information is either a last 4 digits of a taxpayer ID, either that or a driver's license number. And the billing is handled by the University of California at Riverside billing office, and they request that for the billing. And at the time of the order, there's no payment required. They will send you a bill later. When your budwood ships, it goes by FedEx, and you'll receive an email telling you when to expect it. Back when I did the scion exchanges, I remember one frustrating experience where I grafted something and a couple years later realized it wasn't what I thought I was going to get. With the CCPP, you're not going to have that sort of experience. That's another great benefit. Send the email. In this case, the email was sent on a weekday, and within a couple of hours, we had a response. So here's the response. The response has a username and password. So we go back to the CCP webpage, click on Budwood again, accept the terms and conditions, click the button to log in. Then we go back to the email, and you can just copy and paste the username and password. Then click the button to log in. And here we choose the screen house budwood order form. And for delivery method, we choose FedEx. That's the only choice. The one thing that's so nice about this program compared to the scion exchanges is there are hundreds of varieties to choose from. And the budwood cuttings are every single month, so you can graft when you'd like to. And here we choose 6 buds of this new pigmented navel orange, California Rojo. 6 buds of Sarawak Pumelo. Six buds of Tongdi Pumelo. Six buds of Kino low-seeded mandarin. The final is 6 buds of Persian lime. There are a couple of those to choose from, but the newest one is the one to choose, 708 for the Persian lime. And click proceed to order verification. Double check it. Looks good. So click to submit the order. then all we have to do is wait, and very soon the budwood will show up on your doorstep.
When you receive your budwood order, be sure to open up the documentation here in the FedEx package, and what you'll see is that you have this citrus moving permit. And what you need to do when that arrives is to call your local agricultural commissioner and see if they would like to inspect this before you graft with it. So when you receive it, just look them up. You can Google it, agricultural commissioner, and then the name of your county. It should come right up. Just give them a call and see if they'd like to take a look at it. When you open the box, you'll find that there's documentation for each variety ordered that shows the source tree, which has been tested and shown free of citrus disease.
When your scions arrive, be sure to put them in the refrigerator until you're ready to graft. And keep the leftovers around in the refrigerator in case your graft fails. They should be good for several months.